Hello everyone. So today we are going to talk about reverse in C++. So here we are having a vector with the values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then first we are just printing that values. And then we are calling this function, the reverse function, for reversing the vector. And then again we are calling this function. So reverse function takes two arguments. First is a begin with start from certain point, suppose P1, and will go up to P2, but P2 is not included. Okay, for example, here it starts from beginning. Okay, so v dot begin, we know it points to the first position of the zero index, and then it goes up to second argument is v dot end. So v dot end is nothing but pointing to the end of vector, not this 8, but it is pointing here just after the 8. Okay, so it will not take that value, but it will take 8. Okay, for reversing. So here in this case, the reverse element starts from index 0 till index 7, that is 8 digit. So the reversed value will be from 8 7 6 5 4 3 2 1. Okay, so first of all we'll erase this and let us try to run this code and see what are the output. So let us try to run this code. So the output is as what we expected, 8 7 6 5 4 3 2 1. Okay, now to better understand, we'll take another example. So our reverse part will start from v dot begin plus 2, and it will go up to v dot end minus 2 basically. Okay, so let us see where it starts. Begin, this is begin, this is first v dot begin plus 1, this is v dot begin plus 2. So our reverse part will start from here, and then v dot end. So this is v dot end minus 1. This is v dot minus 1, this is minus 2, and we need to take one position back. So mean it will go up to here. So from here to here, this part will be reversed. So let us try to run this code. So when we the solution is 1, 2, 6, 5, 4, 3, 7, 8 as expected. Okay. So I hope you got the basic idea of reverse function C++. We'll meet in the next video with another interesting fact.